The story of a strong woman.
Sorry.
Sent on an important mission.
I forgot myself for a moment. Sorry, I didn't mean to.
During which she will discover her life's true purpose.
Did we climb all the way here just for this?
Her name is...
You.
The Cloisters is here!
None is fine.
INDIKA. The story of a nun told as a racing game?
No.
A loot-based RPG?
No.
A city builder?
No.
An arcade game?
Not.
A walking sim?
No.
A survival horror?
Not.
As a comedy?
No.
Or a tragedy?
No.
No, none of that. INDIKA.
There's a basket for Smaragda in the warehouse. She's waiting.
What does it mean to be truly righteous? To never succumb to temptation, or to take a vow of chastity despite constant temptation? Our heroine did not know the answer to this question, and preferred never to dwell on it. If it were up to her, she would have chosen the quiet life of a nun. However, destiny had something different in store for her.
Thank you.
sorry. Maybe I can help.
You're the last person I need right now. Get lost.
Sorry. For the sake of the prayers of all the Stesha, do you have something prepared for Smaragda?
cold today, isn't it? Oh, potato. Thank you. Thank you.
The sisters laughed, Indika. Christian love is known to be patient, merciful, and faithful. However, in a lowly human sense, they didn't love her that much. To be completely honest, they didn't love her at all. Many of them felt nothing but disgust for her. Indika, however, was not to blame. Were it not for the voice that was inculcating ideas in her, unforgivable for a Christian, she would have been a virtuous and rather mediocre nun. Indika's biggest dream was for that voice to leave her alone once and for all. Her entire life became a struggle, a painful resistance. No matter how hard she tried, no matter how much she tortured herself, the voice grew louder and more convincing every day.
drink some water.
Useless labor is the basis of spiritual development. Obedience is above fasting or prayers. Indika didn't understand why she needed to retrieve the water from the well if there was a pump next door that took it from a sacred spring. She didn't understand why drinking from the spring was allowed, but cooking soup was a sin. The well was only about 15 meters away from the spring. It was not possible to have any other water there. Even a tenth of it is the same. They say, on Epiphany, even a drop of holy water blesses an entire canister. If that were true, a couple of evaporated drops from the spring would bless the puddles beneath her.
You haven't eaten even 10 of them. With God's help, we'll make it to spring. No way. Sisters won't eat after her.
Mother, the sign of the cross saves from the plague. But this... God forgive me.
Glory to... Smaragda, don't tempt me. I'm sending Evdokia to you. Don't let this one into the refectory.
Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May my communion of thy immaculate mysteries, O Lord, not be judged or condemned, but heal the body and soul. Servant of God, servant of God, INDIKA, shall now take communion with the body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior, Jesus Christ.
It is forbidden to leave the convent without a blessing. Despite her requests, INDIKA had not been blessed to leave for a full year. When she was tasked with delivering the letter, it took her completely by surprise. Even though she did not know the contents of that letter, she could not shake the feeling that it would play an extremely important, perhaps critical, role in her life.
What's in it? What is in it? What's in it?
What's in it? What's in it? What's in it? What's in it?
For the sake of the prayers of all the saints, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us. Tisha, I need to go to the other side. Georgie, pirate, be quiet.
The animals feel the unholiness.
They're just happy to see me. Tisha, I'm sorry.
The animals feel the unholiness.
I brought you some apples. Orlovka, your favorite. Tisha, I must hurry to the train. Tisha, what have you done? Steps are all wet. You'll slip and fall again. Don't worry, Tichon, I understand. Forgive me, for Christ's sake.
We'll all be there at some point.
Tichon has the key. Oh, what an imbecile.
INDIKA loved Tichon. Imbecile was a medical diagnosis, so she was just using the word literally. In any case, Tichon couldn't hear her. Hypocrisy isn't really a virtue, is it? It was as if the convent didn't want to let her go. Even though she knew there was no place closer to God, she yearned to leave it, at least for a short time.
Not true!
I think deep inside she hated her monastic cell. Smaragda's tasteless.
Is the
old women that even incense could not cover. Half of the sisters couldn't even read. Even if the abbess was literate, she surely didn't go out of her way to use that skill. Just like her personal hygiene, always.
Someone was wounded, so have I also.
With her finger. Indika hated endless prayers that were repeated so much they lost their original meaning. Hated to smile at fuming candles, the rotting potatoes, the never-ending advice and lectures, the humility, the fear of God. Every yawn. After entering the refectory, praying before entering her cell, before going to sleep, before having a meal, repenting what she had thought or heard, listening to the depressing sister's choir, the dissonant change ringing, signing the cross. To be interested in the lives of the saints, apologizing, repenting, praying, apologizing, endless oaths, the black veils, apologizing, crying, apologizing,
Sorry.
Jesus Christ, what are you doing here? You.
The Cloisters is here!
Nun is fine.
The Conventual is here!
The Nun.
Listen, you're lucky to bump into me. I keep missing and I'm not good at this.
Just, what?
Go. Get out of here. What? Who's there?
To bump into him. He's
not a great shot.
Yes.
Sorry, I can help if you let me.
I don't think it can be helped. His nobleness has decided to listen to the visitation one last time. So let him listen. Don't interrupt.
Excuse me, what happened here?
Have you heard the joke about a crowbar in a train toilet? So, there was this train with a bunch of convicts. They put a spring between two carriages while the train was moving. Tried to plan an escape, I guess.
How many died?
Mostly fugitives. Many of them were shot. They've had to care for the sick.
Me? Of course. We often have to.
Then come with us to the station. All the wounded are there.
He says the wounded are waiting at the station and then injects a corpse with morphine. Maybe out of respect for his dying wish, or for the size of his epaulets. What do you think?
Husband?
Husband?
I guess he was loved.
No.
Since when do you obey me? Worry. Fear is a natural reaction, life-saving in most cases. What is your goal? To help the girl, or show what a hero you are?
To help.
Exactly. If you're trying to help, there's no chance.
Calculating chances in a time like this. How low.
Listen to her. Doesn't like getting abandoned in the middle of an act.
What?
What? Did you see the size of that thing? Maybe you wanted to join them.
Not bad, I...
Didn't have enough, you motherfucker! Back at it again.
Hold on. Wait!
Quiet. Stop yelling.
You've saved me, and I've saved someone too. Poor girl, a little more, and she could have... Lord have mercy on for us. You didn't see, but she got away. Well, I don't know how much, but if it weren't for me, I can't deliver ourselves from... Sorry, what is your name?
Ilya.
Indika. You know, they say that every hour that a patient doesn't get medical attention, their chance of survival is halved. Crazy thing to say, to be honest. It makes no sense to generalize like that. Do we include every case, even a pricked finger? Of course, the doctors say that to look more respectable.
No idea where to take it or where it came from.
Sister! Did you arrive safely? No incidents? Kasyuk, is that you? Wait a second!
You drop your weapon. Drop it!
You drop your weapon! Throw your rifle here! Don't taint your conscience with sin.
You're going nowhere, mate. All right? Manage.
I've got nothing to lose.
Fine, just... But don't shoot, all right?
Do it like this.
Get on him. I'm telling you, go. Get on. Going! I'm telling you!
Come on in! Go on again!
now, or I'll kill you! I'll kill you right here! Look, I've had it! Stop! Look, I've had it now, just stop! Stop it, now, or I'll kill you! I'll kill you right here! Scoundrel! Just wait! Stand!
Eyes on the road.
Why are you aiming your revolver at me?
Wait!
You won't
please
shoot me.
And
why is that?
I'm not running anymore! Stop. You are scum!
Wait.
Just
so
come back! Just wait! Do it again! Come back! I'll shoot you! Just wait! Here! Hooligan, stop where you are! Right now! We'll shoot! You bitch! Stop! Scoundrel! Kill you! I'll shoot you! Just come back!
Eyes on the road.
Why are you aiming your revolver at me?
Scum!
You won't shoot
just
me.
Come back! Just
if you go faster, I will.
You! Hooligan,
wait.
Stop where you are! Right now! Hooligan! Come back! Just wait! Stand! I'll shoot you! We'll shoot! You bitch! You fucking bitch! I've had enough! Just stop! Stop me! Now! Or I'll kill you!
Hey. Are you wounded? This is good.
No, what are you doing?
say. Get up. No, 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 you don't need that. Let's go. Well, either with me or with them, up to you.
So much.
Sorry. We're doing no more than 5 verse an hour, though.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. How do you understand it, huh?
Is he talking about the word versed, or how to start an engine?
I grew up in a bike shop. My father sold them.
In Spasov?
Why in Spasov? No, in Gorodishi. I've never been to Spasov.
That's where I grew up.
The man's logic is flawless.
Are you embarrassed to be so close to a man?
She's been waiting for that. He's quite a looker, huh? Thick boy.
Oh, I must smell awful. You know, they kept us in the train for 3 days.
Oh, don't worry. She likes it.
Oh! Pardon.
Come on, grab her tits.
Hey!
Stop pretending. He's just like the men you imagine in your room when you're...
Enough!
All right, calm down.
And is he a bandit or a sissy?
Hold on to your seat, for God's sake.
We'll be right back.
Hey. Are you all right? I'm sorry, can I take a look, please?
There's nothing to look at. You better give me an injection.
Oh my god. I'm afraid this will happen. If we don't amputate it, you won't survive the afternoon.
Your prison doctor, he told me the same thing. Word for word. But that was over a week ago.
And he didn't do anything?
Sadly, the only surgical equipment he had was a rusty wash basin.
Very funny.
All right. All right. Don't worry. It should be like that. Only like that. I'm also talking to God.
To God? Great. You need to get up if you don't want to lose something else to frostbite.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.